did it all. We did it all. We did whatever we get our hands on back in the 70s. We did fucking handfuls of mushrooms, pills, lewds, coke, whatever it was. We just fucking swallowed it, okay? That's what we did. People go, well, why don't you go into rehab? We didn't have rehab back in the 70s. Back in the 70s, rehab meant you'd stop doing coke, but you kept smoking pot and drinking for a couple more weeks, you know? Yeah, give me a case of Budweiser and an ounce. I gotta slow down. Jesus Christ. I'm out of control. Look at the size of my pants, for Christ's sake. Because that's the big thing now. Rehab is the big fucking secret now, isn't it, huh? Yeah, you can do whatever you want. Just go into rehab and solve your problems. Isn't that the big celebrity thing? That's what I'm going to do. Yeah, I'm going to get famous. Then my career starts to flag. I'm going to go on a three-month fucking bender, okay? Coke and fucking pot and smack and fucking booze and drive over people and beat up my kids. Go into therapy. Go into rehab. Come out of rehab. Be on the cover of People magazine. Sorry. I fucked up. That's what they do, man. They go into rehab and they come out and they blame everybody except themselves. They blame their parents, right? That's the way everybody comes from a dysfunctional family all of a sudden, huh? Roseanne Barr comes from a dysfunctional family? Not Roseanne. She seems so normal to me. The Jacksons were dysfunctional? Not the Jacksons. These people give each other new heads for Christmas, for Christ's sake. I am sick and tired of hearing that fucking speech, you know? These people come out of rehab and they always have the same story. Well, you know, I became an alcoholic because my parents didn't love me enough. And then I became a junkie because my parents didn't love me enough. And I went into hypnosis and therapy and I found out that my parents used to hit me. Hey, my parents used to beat the living shit out of me, okay? And looking back on it, I'm glad they did. And I'm looking forward to beating the shit out of my kids, aren't you? For no reason whatsoever. What'd you hit me for? Shut up and get out there and mow the lawn, for Christ's sake. There's therapy for you, mowing the lawn and crying at the same time. The Leary kids in therapy again. Their lawn looks great. It's unbelievable. God.
I'm just not happy. I'm just not happy. I'm just not happy because my life didn't turn out the way I thought it would.
Hey, join the fucking club, okay? I thought I was going to be the starting center fielder for the Boston Red Sox. Life sucks. Get a fucking helmet, all right?
I'm not happy. I'm not happy.
Nobody's happy, okay? Happiness comes in small doses, folks. It's a cigarette or a chocolate chip cookie or a five-second orgasm. That's it, okay? You come, you eat the cookie, you smoke the butt, you go to sleep, you get up in the morning and go to fucking work, okay? That is it. End of fucking list. I'm just not happy. Shut the fuck up, all right? That's the name of my new book, Shut the Fuck Up by Dr. Dennis Leary. A revolutionary new form of therapy. I'm gonna have my patients come in, doctor, I shut the fuck up, next. I don't feel so, shut the fuck up, next.
He made me feel so much better about myself, you know? He just told me to shut the fuck up, and nobody had ever told me that before. I feel so much better now.
Whining fucking maggots. Well, here's to all you people who can't drink anymore. Still tastes fucking great. I take every day, one beer at a time, every beer, one sip at a time. See, I think alcohol, same problem we had with drugs. Alcohol was fine if we had left it alone. Alcohol was fine when it was the four basic groups, right? Beer, gin, whiskey, and vodka, because then you had to like the taste of it, right? Yeah, you've all made that whiskey face. You know, you take a shot of whiskey, you can't help but make that whiskey face because it tastes so strong. You take the shot and you go, ah! Eh? You've seen those 65-year-old men sitting around in bars with the permanent whiskey face on?
I got it.
Fucking giants, huh? Jesus Christ, I don't know why. I gotta get going, I'll see you guys later. Take it easy, huh? That was the whole point. If you're gonna drink it, you're gonna look that way, okay? You're gonna get that burning sensation in your chest. That's the whole fucking point. So how'd they get around that problem? They invented schnapps, the crack of alcohol, right? For all the people who want to get fucked up but don't like the taste of it, new bubblegum schnapps, folks. Two things that should not be put together, bubblegum and fucking drinking, okay? They do not go hand in hand, and you've all had that Satan schnapps experience where you're out with somebody who's drinking the schnapps, and they all drink the same way, because it's like candy going down. So that first half hour, you're just like sipping at a beer, maybe? They're pouring down that fucking bottle. I got fucking bubblegum schnapps, I'm fine. Half an hour later, driving home with the Tasmanian devil in the backseat. Like, we gotta get him off. He wakes up the next morning and his liver is sitting next to him having a cup of coffee. Going, you're an asshole. Shut up and get back in my body. And all these people quitting, look, I think it's a good thing, AA, and the recovery and rehab, because I've got some friends who would be dead without those programs. But you know something? Now we have a different problem, because now they quit drinking and drugs, they're completely stressed out, and they decide to work out, which is fine. I'm not a workout guy, but I understood Nautilus. It made sense. There were arm machines and leg machines. But have you seen these people who are using the Stairmaster? Huh? Have we turned into gerbils, ladies and gentlemen? People are paying money to go into a health club and walk up invisible steps over and over again for an hour and a half. Where are you going? I'm going up, and I paid for it, too. I can stay here as long as I want, folks. You want to go up and downstairs, move into a fifth floor, walk up on the Lower East Side, okay? What's next, the fucking Stairmaster? I sit down, I get up, I sit down, I get up, I sit down, I get up. The Doormaster, I open the door, I close. What the fuck? And I'll tell you something else right now. I have the solution to the drug problem in this country. Nobody wants to hear it, but I have it. Not less drugs, more drugs. Get more drugs and give them to the right fucking people. Because every time you read about some famous guy overdosing on drugs, it's always some really talented guy. It's always like Len Bias or Janis Joplin or Jimi Hendrix or John Belushi, you know what I mean? The people you want to have overdose on drugs never would. Like Motley Crue would never fucking overdose, man, never. You could put them in a room with 2 tons of crack. They come out a half an hour later, oh, man, oh, God. Shit, they're still alive. Fuck. They're probably going to make a double live album now. God damn it! I take music pretty seriously. You see that scar on my wrist? You see that? You know what that's from? I heard the Bee Gees were getting back together again. I couldn't take it, okay? That was the only good thing about the 1980s. We got rid of one of the Bee Gees. One down, three to go. That's what I say, folks. Yeah, here's $10. Bring me the head of Barry Manilow, all right? I want to drink beer out of his empty head. I want to have a Barry Manilow skull keg party at my apartment, okay? You write the songs, we'll drink the beer out of your head. We live in a country where John Lennon takes 6 bullets in the chest. Yoko Ono was standing right next to him. Not one fucking bullet. Explain that to me. Explain it to me, God. Explain it to me, God. I want it explained to me now. Jesus. Now we got 25 more years. Yeah, I'm real fucking happy now, God. I'm wearing a huge happy hat. Jesus Christ. I mean, Steve Ray Vaughan is dead. And we can't get John Bon Jovi in a helicopter. Come on, folks. Get on that helicopter, John. Shut the fuck up and get on that helicopter. There's a hairdresser in there. Yeah, go ahead in there. Yeah, yeah. I don't get it. You know, I just don't get it. I missed the fucking point someplace. The boat left and I wasn't on the boat. Explain it to me. Heavy metal bands on trial because kids commit suicide. What is that about? Judas Priest on trial because my kid bought the record and he listened to the lyrics and he got into Satan. Well, that's great. That sets a legal precedent. Does that mean I can sue Dan Fogelberg for making me into a pussy in the mid-70s? Is that possible, huh? Your Honor, between him and James Taylor, I didn't get a blowjob till I was 27 years old. I was in Colorado wearing hiking boots, eating granola. I want some fucking money right now. Let me make sure I am crystal clear on this issue, okay? Heavy metal fans are buying heavy metal records, taking the records home, listening to the records, and then blowing their heads off with shotguns? Where's the problem? That's an unemployment solution right there, folks. It's called natural selection. It's the bottom of the fucking food chain, okay? I say we put more messages on the records. Kill the band, kill your parents, then yourself, okay? Make sure you get your whole head in front of the shotgun. Thank you for calling. Thank you for calling. Let me tell you something. We need a 2.5-hour movie about the Doors, folks. No, we don't. I could sum it up for you in 5 seconds, okay? I'm drunk. I'm nobody. I'm drunk. I'm famous. I'm drunk. I'm fucking dead. There's the whole movie, okay? Big, fat, dead guy in a bathtub. There's your title for you.